we're seeing it in the ONE Championship cage for the very first time. Three knockdowns in one round and the contest is over. There is no competition on the ground. You can't grapple on the ground. You can lock your hands around an opponent's neck and control them in the clinch, whereby you throw the knees to the body, the knees to the jaw. You can also knee to the leg. No groin strikes are allowed. No headbutts allowed. You see a southpaw stance on Sam A in the black and red. Look out for the lightning fast and powerful kicks. You'll see Lasiri try and get on the inside and lock on the Muay Thai clinch.
He's immediately trying to go for it, like he's trying to cut the cage off like he would normally corner one of his opponents inside a ring, but there's no corners here, so the cage is actually working to Sam A's advantage, and he's able to move laterally.
Cracking roundhouse kick there by Sam A, double forearm guard from Lasiri. Muay Thai athletes will try and kick to an opponent's arms to break down the forearms, cause them to drop their arms, then come over the top looking for a knockout. That did not count as a knockdown, folks, just a push kick there from Sam A. But it does show the power, the precision, the timing of the great Sam A. He lands a body shot. There's a cutting side kick. There's a tip kick and a high left roundhouse kick. You can throw your opponent to the ground in Muay Thai. It's called a dump. Now, technically, it won't score for you, but it takes a psychological toll on your opponent. They have to physically pick themselves up off the canvas. You can also, when you dump them, follow your opponent down to the canvas and drive a knee in. But, of course, you can't engage them once they're down.
Sam A looks so relaxed, so calm. You can see Lasiri's trying to rush in, trying to get a hold of him, but he just can't find an answer to Sam A.
Pranchet on the left arm of Lasiri has actually fallen down to his wrist, and it would not be beyond referee Olivia Costia to stop it and maybe cut off that armband. Tracking leg kick there from Sam A. Massive tree trunk thighs on the Thai megastar. The man who beat the great Pech Bunchu not once, not twice, but three times. Knocked him out twice. Two-time Lumpini champion. Lumpini, one of the two mega stadiums in Thailand, the other being Ranjitthvan. If you're a champion of either one of those stadiums, you are the best in the world. Big high left roundhouse kick there from Sam A. The roundhouse kicks of Muay Thai are the hardest kicks in the martial arts world. And the Muay Thai knee has been tested to be the hardest strike in all of martial arts. Oh, he tags him with a nice right hand. No knockdown, though, says referee Olivier Coste. Roundhouse kick again. Crack to the ribs, and Sam A blocks away the round. Now, in Muay Thai, we do score round by round. Three judges cage side are scoring on a 10-point must system. Brandon Vera, your 10-point must card after one round.
After one round, it was all damage by all Sam A. It was a dominant performance. There's no other way to describe it. No other way.
10-9 round. You're going to agree here, Mitch. You'll go 10-9 for Sam A in the first.
Maybe 10-8. The way that Sam A is evading the strikes of Lasiri. He's parrying to the left, countering, has him off balance. He is in control of every aspect of this match, and it's only going to get better and better as the match wears on.
Traditionally in Thailand, the bouts do start very slow. The first round is usually filling up process because of the live betting in the stadiums on the Muay Thai contest. Not the case here tonight. Hence, we've seen Sam A come out strongly, cracking with those trademark roundhouse kicks off both legs, to the legs, the body, and up to the neck of Joseph Lasiri. Second round. Lasiri, you can see the damage already on the ribs, on the face, on the legs. The hematoma is starting to open up. Lasiri's got to get on the inside of these roundhouse kicks and lock on the grapple.
He's trying to reach in, but Sam A is just parrying these shots and utilizing the angles, so it's very hard for Lasiri to get in tight to utilize his clinch.
As opposed to a boxer, you will see the Muay Thai guard, the arms turned out, all the forearms almost facing the opponent. That's to be able to catch those roundhouse kicks and catch the elbows that come at you. course, Muay Thai known as the art of eight weapons. Two hands, two feet, two knees, two elbows. Lasiri tries for a hook. Samay almost catches him with a rising knee. Always composed, collected, Samay Gaiyanghadao. High left roundhouse kick. He's had about 300 matches more than the Italian. Up there's another roundhouse kick high. Olivia Cost this time applies a standing eight count. It'll go to the count of eight.
Okay.
Lasiri.
Okay.
Looks like he's going to continue here. And Olivia Cost gets us back underway. Three knockdowns in one round. It will be over automatically. High roundhouse again. The headache maker from Samay. He's looking for the finish now. Is Samay Gaiyanghadao?
I don't think Lasiri's going to get his round. The timing of Samay is starting to land. He's attacking both the front and the rear leg of Lasiri. And he's throwing him off balance.
And as you see Samay pick up the tempo, you hear the Sarama music in the background also pick up the tempo. They're in the clinch now. That's where Lasiri could do damage, but Samay breaks off. Look at the damage under the, well, on the deltoid, the bicep and the back there of Lasiri from those roundhouse kicks. It looks like he's been barbecued. He takes a tumble, center cage. Olivia Cost puts on the second count of the round. One more knockdown will be over. Lasiri wants to go on. And Samay comes forward. Here comes the heavy artillery again. Samay knocks him down. It's good night, Irene. Knockout in the second round. The great Samay Gaiyanghadao does it again. And for the first time ever in the ONE Championship Cage. Look out for the sneakiness, the angles, the speed of Wilson. Look out for the sheer, unadulterated power of Samay Gaiyanghadao, particularly in his rear leg roundhouse kick. Now, elbows are permitted, knees are permitted. You can grapple for as long as you like under these Muay Thai rules, so long as you keep the action flowing. Wilson hunts for the inside lead thigh against the southpaw. Wants to keep his lead foot on the outside of Sam A's lead foot and throw the right hand. Roundhouse kick there from Sergio. Inside leg from Wilson. High kick from Sam A.
Big power thrown by Sam A. Attacking that lead, that rear arm of Sergio Wilson as Sergio goes to work on the lead leg of Sam A. Push kick from Sam A.
Nice work off the back leg from Sam A. The push kick known as a teep in Muay Thai. Jab to find the range here from Wilson. There's the roundhouse kick that time off the left leg from Sam A. So much power in that rear leg of the Thai. Four-ounce gloves being used here. Looks for the inside leg to Sergio. Goes up to the body. Samay tries to lop his head off.
Go!
Cracking roundhouse kick. Both men exchange. Went to the body, did Samay. Went to the inside thigh, did Wilson. Once again, southpaws are open to the inside thigh kicks and powerful inside thigh kicks off the rear leg.
Rather than taking it, accepting that big arm kick that Sergio Wilson, that Sam A's throwing on Sergio Wilson, Sergio Wilson's countering immediately right back with that inside leg kick.
A very good opening round here. Not too much of a feeling out process. A lot of heavy artillery. Sam A! Almost stumbled. Wilson put everything into that beautiful right roundhouse. Straight right hand to dump there. From Sam A. Now it's not a knockdown, it's a dump. You can throw your opponent to the canvas. It deflates them both mentally and physically. Inside leg high up that femur profunda from Sam A. Gaiyanghadao. final seconds of what has been a very good contest. Roundhouse kick there from Wilson. One championship star, Rika Ishige, also in the audience here amongst our many women. It is great to see the tiny doll, Rika Ishige. Sam A. Gaiyanghadao, you may be wondering about some of the last names of these ties, like Fairtex Gaiyanghadao. The ties do traditionally take their last name as their gym name or of a major sponsor. Usually it's a gym name.
Beautiful redirection there and dump from Sam A. Caught him just off balance and dumped Sergio Wilson to the ground. That doesn't score any points, but it shows dominance by the person thrown to the ground.
Both looking very relaxed, very composed. No real damage to be seen so far. Both men have traded kicks exceptionally well. It's been Wilson going
seconds
to the leg area. Sam A going to the body and
seconds
at times looking for the head. In front of a sellout crowd at the Singapore Indoor Stadium, it's one championship Super Series for the first time ever. World championship
round
up for grabs
two.
In the flyweight division. Two men who know what world titles are all about. Between them, I believe they hold more than 8 world titles combined. Inside leg, then up to the ribs. Double left roundhouse kick from Sam A. Gaiyanghadao.
Those kicks are catching Sergio Wilson flat on the back with just an absolute thud.
Sam A controlling center cage. You got to figure that everything presentable in the Muay Thai world, Sam A has seen at some stage. 365 career wins for the Thai. One for every day of the year. Inside leg, looking for it, is Sergio Wilson. Wilson also cuts a very unassuming figure, did so in line fight, came in very underrated, shocked the world on quite a few occasions as he became the world champion after being a virtual unknown outside of Europe.
I'd like to see Sergio start to initiate some attacks. He's kind of waiting for Sam A to throw something, and then he's countering back. That time, caught him with a leg kick first, and you can see the reddening on the inside of Sam A's thigh starting to show.
Looks to the inside leg again. Does Wilson. Striking roundhouse kick there from Sam A. Across the jab. Hands up high. Ribs a little exposed here on Sam A. Will Sergio choose to lift his kicks up a little? There's an overhand left from the Dutchman. Spinning back elbow, missed the target. Fantastic match here, Mitch. Plenty of action. Set for 5 rounds, of course, for a world championship match.
Yeah, very technical. They're just trying to pace each other. So this is a 5-rounder. So most of our matches have in the Super Series have been 3 rounds. So you see a lot more fast-paced action. This time, this is a little bit more like traditional Muay Thai, how these first couple rounds are just a feeling out process. Throwing a shot, seeing how your opponent reacts. And as the match goes on, you're going to start to see the speed and tempo of both these athletes start to pick up.
Leaps forward now to Sam A. Gaiyanghadao. Sergio using angles. He's dancing. Is the man from Holland. Tracks away the roundhouse kick again to Sam A. Wilson, of course, born in Suriname. The pedigree of Surinamese kickboxers is extraordinary. The likes of Tyrone Spock, Remy Bunjaski, Ernesto Hoost. The list goes on. Back elbow, oh, the elbow from Sam A! But no knockdown, says referee Onari.
Beautiful timing, avoided the punch and came in and answered with a knee.
And there it is, end of the round, we go to the towels. Wherever you're watching in 138 countries around the world and live on the One Super App. How are you scoring this one? It is 3 judges cage side on a 10-point must system, which means you give the winning combatant 10 points, the losing combatant 9 points for that round.
Now we're starting to see Sergio Wilson go first, initiate a lot of these exchanges. There's that beautiful evasion of the punch, answered with a knee, and spun Sergio Wilson around. Very dominant performance so far. from Sam A. Sergio Wilson is in there. He's in there with all the exchanges. And with little gloves, the tide can turn on the turn of a dime. But at this point, Sam A is starting to inch forward.
Seconds out, please.
Sellout crowd here inside Singapore Indoor Stadium. Third round of five for the World Muay Thai title in one super series. And if you're watching it live on the all-free championship super app, if you're enjoying it, if you're not, go on the App Store, download it. All live, all fights, all free. Could we see a potential contender for the Go Daddy knockout of the night here?
Go, go, go.
There is a lot of reddening on the inside lead leg of Sam A. As I said, southpaws are open to getting those leg kicks to the inside thigh. And there's one again from Wilson. This is good work from Sergio. Blocks the high kick.
That high kick just barely didn't get through there. It looked like his toes touched him on the chin.
Overhand elbow. A lot of speed there from Sam A. There's a crossing elbow. Looks for a dunk. Good defense from Sergio Wilson. I like the way that Sergio started this round, Mitch.
Very impressive. Even on that clinch, he was able to get inside, maintain the base, and not allow Sammy to dump him down. We're starting to see Sergio step it up a little bit, but he's going all the way around. And look at the timing of Sam A. As Sergio goes all the way around with the kick, Sam A times the kick to come right up the middle.
Sam A fakes off the back leg. The southpaw tie. Arms turned outwards, as most ties do, to catch the elbows, to catch the kicks from their opponent. Good outside leg kick from Sam A.
Sergio's got to circle out, doesn't want to stand there in the middle of Sam A.
Like a whip cracking against the forearms, and that one around the neck. But Wilson rides it. Goes high in his own accord to the upper left rib cage of Sam A. They clinch up now, got to work the knees, got to stay busy. Neither man getting a superior clinch here though, Mitch.
Yeah, so that goes a lot. That shows you a lot from Sergio Wilson. He's able to really just kind of shut down the clinch of Sam A. And Sam A's known as being a great redirector and dumping people down.
Double roundhouse kicks from Sam A. There's three in a row from the tie. Sergio resets, tried to catch Sam A as he was coming in. We're going to lock on the tie clinch, and Sergio has got it, but he gets stuck to the canvas like yesterday's garbage.
Beautifully done from Sam A. Catches Sergio Wilson a little bit off balance, puts him on his butt.
20 seconds remaining, third round of five. It's been a seesawing battle. A clash of roundhouse kicks. Little teeth to the lead leg there from Wilson. Gets out of the way of the high left roundhouse. That one cracks to the upper right ribs. Goes to the carcass again and sends Wilson back against the cage. Three rounds down, two to go. It's an absolute cracker.
Now we're entering the championship round of the inaugural Muay Thai 1 Super Series Flyweight World Championship. Beautifully done by Sam A. Look at that. Just good head movement, sidestepping, laterally moving that timing that I was talking about. Avoids the high kick, answers back with one of his own, and forces Sergio Wilson to kind of answer back in a little frustration by throwing the leg off. Now we are scoring these 10-point must, Michael. Unofficial scorecard. What do you see?
After three rounds, this is very close, Mitch. I would edge it ahead to Sam A. Gaiyanghadao, but Sergio Wilson is definitely abandoning, particularly to the inside lead leg of Gaiyanghadao. The harder strikes are coming from the Thai. Good volume, though, from both men. Two more rounds to go. Muay Thai rules, penultimate round now. Crowd loving everyone. One super series. Big roundhouse kick off the bell from Sam A. And again.
And This is the fourth round. This is usually the most important round in Muay Thai. So you guys can expect these two to put it all out there.
Oh, Samay Gaiyanghadao, more kick than a drowning horse here in the fourth round. Wilson's got to be careful. If he comes in, he's got to commit. Goes to the inside thigh again of Gaiyanghadao. Plenty of instructions coming from the corner of Samay. Knee guard there from Sergio. Pushes out the front kick. Oh, you hear the pounding into the ribs from Samay. My word. And Sergio Wilson taking the punishment and coming back. The cagey, sneaky, touch combatant.
Sergio Wilson's showing a little move, so you can see him take that kick and just start to ride it and walk with it from that power from Sam A. But a nice straight left hand.
Sergio tries to catch him coming in. Beautifully done there from Sam A. Gaiyanghadao. A little Muay Thai tricks of a super experienced veteran. Wilson ties him up, tried for the elbow off the right arm. Oh, nice dunk from Sambay. Muay Thai 101. The little tour, the pivot, the move.
Oh, the big kibosh! The big kibosh! He caught him swiftly, and down went Wilson.
Six, seven.
That was a huge elbow from Sambay Gaiyanghadao.
Right as Sergio Wilson stepped in, the beautiful timing of Sam A caught him flush on the chin.
And now Sam A, the aggressimator, is off the charge for the Thai legend. Inside leg from Sergio. Has he fully recovered from the knockdown? They clinch up against the cage. Sam A again, devastating on the inside. Knee from Sam A, elbow. High left roundhouse kick. Wilson's taking heavy shots now. Sam A tags it. Uppercut elbow. And another one. He dropped him again. He dropped him again. Second knockdown from Sam A getting him down. This is crazy. This is awesome.
Who says it's just crazy to be here, loves the atmosphere, loves the event, and is primed to take his position amongst the elite here in the ONE Championship fold.
Well, now I'm going up on a tough test here today. The former ONE Flyweight World Champion, former Super Flyweight Champion of Lupini, Samay is one of the best in the game.
One of the best, right? See the composure from Samay, can't you? Into his stance, comfortable in his body. Roland, very busy, jumping up and down, hands moving, legs moving, exchanging kicks at the moment. Roland will be very happy to mix it. Oh, but he takes a left hand and smiles through it. Wasn't going to get any respite from the referee. Still smiling, but that certainly landed and certainly woke him up. And that's how Samay can just pick you off. Look at the way he moves, great economy of effort, strides towards you.
And everything just so calculated, no sudden movements by Sammy.
Understands the geography of the circle just as he understands the geography of a squared ring supremely well. Knows how to cover that ground with the minimum of effort. He misjudged that, didn't he? Went for a spectacular kick, missed completely, landed on his backside. Once again, but this time there was more input from Sam A, tripped him.
Sam A had a long layoff in his last bout. He said that contributed to his performance. But now down to strawweight, feels amazing, he said. Never feel better.
He runs so much. Yeah, cardio is not going to be an issue for him, is it? Controlling his weight, not going to be an issue. Moment, landing punches at will, not an issue either. Knee, brings that knee up to the head.
Short elbow there inside the clinch for Sammy.
Stop! Separate!
And Roland looking at the moment as if he just needs to settle down a little bit. as all of that composure from the Thai athlete is coming through supremely well for now. Look at the way he just cuts, eats up the space between him and his opponent. And once again, Roland sent to his backside. 40 seconds left in this opening round. Another big left hand from Sam A. He just picks them off, doesn't he?
Sam A going hands and low kicks with this bout against a taller opponent. Wants to neutralize the movement and the height. Get in with his punches and land low kicks to slow him down.
How can he make this rangy height difference work in his advantage, the Frenchman? Is the top. Oh, that's a good right hand, and he drops Sam A to his knees. That'll give him tremendous confidence right at the end of the round, because we were seeing the Thai athlete really come to prominence over this first 3 minutes. Big confidence booster. To add to that super right-hand punch that dropped Sam A, there was a nice elbow just as the bell rang there. Let's have another look at some of the actions.
Here's the straight left that stumbled Roland. Kicks to the body, but this was the shot that hurt Sam A. Just the right hook off the kick of Sam A.
And he had the presence of mind, Gianni, to follow it up with the knee as well. He's looking for that stoppage, and that's what he can produce. Sam A, as controlled and comfortable as he looks, cannot relax here.
Cannot. Darren Roland is an experienced opponent. He's the champion as well, and he's hungry, looking for a big debut here in ONE Championship.
Doesn't get much bigger to make your debut than this event. ONE Century, we're in Tokyo, Japan. It's the 100th event in ONE Championship history, part one of a doubleheader.
Okay, ready, ready, bump!
5 3-minute rounds, we've had one of them. Potentially 12 more minutes to come, and judges will score this round by round using the 10-point mark system. The exchange of kicks early in this round, and the pace has increased as compared with the first 3 minutes. Sam A has really stepped things up.
And Sam A going back to the low kicks, chopping on the long legs of Roland.
He got a bit of a surprise towards the end of that round, didn't he? And maybe that just told him that he needs to just move things up a level. It's a marathon, not a sprint. 5 rounds here, and Sam A knows that better than anybody.
Roland not phased at all by Sam A. He's throwing back strikes of his own.
Just getting caught on the top of the head, stumbling back into the wall of the circle. What a prospect facing Sam A. Gonna head out. You just cannot hide. We'll catch up with you.
Oh, then look for a spinning elbow.
Twice. Gianni, and he wasn't far off, but Sam
A. Great left! Oh, great left by Sam A.
And sent that left in towards the chin. It doesn't look to me as if Roland's getting up.
Seven,
he's on his back,
eight,
arms to the side.
Nine,
we're at the count of 10, 9, and it's over.
This is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.